The Deputy Chair of the powerful Committee on Intelligence and Security, former Speaker of the House, Andrew Wallace. You've got a number of many farmers in your electorate in Queensland. What's the mood like? Does it diminish the argument at all, given there's such a breadth of issues that are concerning people out there?
Well, Kieran, I just did my tour to Fisher last week, and you know, I travelled through 23 towns, did 23 listening posts. And the feeling towards this government is like what I've never seen before. It is white hot rage. And, you know, there are so many different issues. You know, they're at war with the farmers. They're at war with the Reserve Bank. They're at war even with their own unions now. So, I mean, you know, this government under Anthony Albanese is lurching from one disaster to the next.
And on the RBA, you touched on that. Are you trying to... Is this basically the coalition not giving the government a win when it comes to having the two separate boards of the RBA, which was recommended by the independent review of the central bank?
I know this has got nothing to do with politics. This is ensuring that the RBA remain independent. We don't want to see an RBA that's stacked with unionists, that's stacked with, no matter what government of the day it is, with hand-picked choices of the wrong people on the RBA. It's incredibly important. It's been a fundamental tenet of our economic system that for decades that the RBA remains independent of government.
And do you think the Treasurer is using that as cover for undermining that independence? Is that your concern?
Yeah, I'm very concerned that this whole process that's being undertaken by the Treasurer is designed to try and take the pressure off the government. He wants a situation where he has a bunch of friendlies who are going to make decisions and announcements that are consistent with the government. And look, this goes both ways. Whether it's the Labor Party in government or whether it's us in government, the Reserve Bank must be independent. And we've got to fight for that sort of retention of independence.
You've been arguing for reform when it comes to another matter, that being social media, for a long time in the digital space. Are you welcoming the fact the Prime Minister's showing such urgency this week and saying, we've got to get this legislated this year? Isn't that a good thing?
Well, you know, pardon my cynicism, so young yet so cynical, but, I mean, Peter Dutton came out in June. So what's that, 4 months ago? In June, he was coming out and saying that a coalition government will, in the first 100 days, ensure that children under the age of 16 will not be allowed access onto social media. Now, Peter Malinauskas comes out yesterday and says, you know, something similar, although not quite, he doesn't go quite as strong as what we did. And all of a sudden, the Prime Minister's out there this morning doing an announcement. But what is the announcement? The announcement is that they're going to introduce some form of age restrictions on social media, but he can't tell us even today, 4 months after the announcement, what those age groups will be. And I tell you, I'm on the social media committee that was stood up as a stand...
So do you believe it must be 16?
I do.
There's no compromise on that?
No.
It needs to be 16? It's
a minimum 16. The only reason...
But that being said... Will you hope that there's a compromise? Because this has got to be above politics, surely. Protecting young people from the ills of social media.
Without doubt. Look, there are so many young people and the evidence that we're receiving on the committee has been very, very clear that the amount of harms that are being done to young people, the young lives that where young people are taking their own lives because of the social bullying that's happening... We have got to make a stand on this, but the Prime Minister...
You're willing to put... And I get the critique, and I know that you're saying they've been too slow to this, but are you willing to put that to one side as a coalition and get this done before the end of the year?
Well, provided it's done at the right age group. I don't believe that Malinauskas' approach of allowing parents to decide between ages of 13 and 15 is appropriate. Because you yourself, just in the last segment, were talking about how powerful it is for a parent to be able to say to their daughter or son, I'm sorry, no, Sally or John, the law says 16. You're not 16 yet. You can't have it. And that's That's returning power to the parents. And that's incredibly powerful. We don't want a situation where young people can play their mates and parents off against each other.
No, it's no argument on that front, Andrew Wallace. I think it's a good idea. The time has come. It's got to be done before the end of the year, let's hope.